Hello, and welcome to AI Red Teaming 101, the series where we walk you through the fundamentals of AI Red Teaming. I'm Dr. Amanda Minnich, Principal Research Manager on Microsoft's AI Red Team, and I'm joined by Gary Lopez, Principal Offensive AI Scientist on the Autonomous Defense and Protection Team, ADAPT, and AI Red Team alum.
This course is designed for security professionals, machine learning practitioners, and anyone curious about the risks of generative AI systems. You don't need a PhD or a red teaming background. We'll walk you through the concepts step by step with real-world examples and hands-on techniques.
The content in this course is drawn from the introductory material in our AI Red Teaming training, which we presented at numerous Black Hat events, the NDC Security Conference, and Microsoft internal and customer trainings. It covers the foundational concepts and techniques that we build on more in our advanced courses, including the full in-depth version that we teach at Black Hat.
We've recently open sourced the labs from our training, and this series will teach you the techniques you'll need to complete those labs, including how to craft your own jailbreaks, how to perform prompt injections, and how to run attacks manually and with automation.
You've already heard our titles, but we wanted to take a moment to share a bit more about where we're coming from. So I've been on the AI Red Team for 4 years, 3 as an operator, and now leading our research team, where our goal is to conduct applied research projects focused on the what's next in AI security. I've been working at the intersection of machine learning and security since 2012, and I started out applying machine learning to security problems, like classifying malware at Sandia National Lab and Mandiant, and later detecting election interference and abuse at Twitter using graph clustering methods. Now I focus on attacking AI systems to make them safer before they reach the real world. I also co-founded Align, a community focused on elevating diverse voices for safer AI, because different perspectives are essential for finding risks others might overlook.
I'm a principal offensive AI scientist on the Microsoft's Autonomous Defense and Protection Team, or ADAPT. My work focuses on offensive security for AI systems, agents, and developing real-world attack simulations. I also have a background on national security issues and risk stems from the usage of AI in those contexts. I'm also a former AI Red Team operator, and I am the creator of Pirat. We have a few more modules on Pirat specifically that we will be covering later on. My background is also as a critical infrastructure vulnerability research, where I apply machine learning to better understand and characterize malware samples. Now, as a member of ADAPT, I lead our offensive work. I'm creating adversarial simulations to keep Microsoft more secure.
So before we get started, we wanted to define what is AI red teaming. If you come from a traditional security background, this is going to mean something different than you're used to. The term red teaming historically describes a double-blind process where you're trying to evade detection and go low and slow and see how far you can get in a system. You're emulating real-world, very advanced adversaries like nation-states, and you have mature toolkits and processes. AI red teaming, on the other hand, tends to be single blind. The product team or model owner knows that we're in there and testing, and we emulate both adversarial and benign user personas. We also deal with rapidly evolving tools and processes. Everything is changing very fast all the time. And so this just looks and feels very different from a traditional red teaming operation.
As you may have imagined, generative AI models have built-in risks. Broadly speaking, we could think of them as risk of fabrications, alignment gaps, and risk of prompt injections. Fabrications are when or happen when the model gives you information that is incorrect, but the model is confident about this. You can think of this as perhaps the citations that generative AI models tend to make up as you interact with them. Alignment gaps stem from models learning behavior that is perhaps unintended and is not aligned with what we expected. And then the last group is prompt injection. And this stems from the fact that machine learning models can't really understand the difference between instruction and code, meaning one input stream and it doesn't have any boundaries. So this is where direct and indirect prompt injection comes into play, and our modules later on will go into more detail about this. When we do our red teaming operations, it's important to test for both the safety and the security of these systems in tandems, as it's often the case that they overlap one another.
I also wanted to briefly introduce the Microsoft AI Red Team, which has been around since 2018. So we're responsible for red teaming Microsoft's production AI systems, things like Copilot, generative models, and autonomous agents. And we also evaluate OpenAI models before their release, and we're often the last checkpoint before a system ships. Our team brings together people with backgrounds in offensive security, adversarial machine learning, responsible AI, abuse prevention, privacy, biological safety, and more. And this kind of variety isn't just interesting, it's really necessary. Red teaming generative AI requires different ways of thinking and different kinds of expertise because no one discipline can cover all the risks. That's also why we built the course the way that we did. It's designed so that anyone can jump in, regardless of your background, and build the intuition and hands-on experience to help make these systems safer. So as you go through this course, bring your perspective with you. That's what helps us find the unexpected and stay ahead of new threats.
Thank you for joining Kick Things Off. Next, we'll dive into how generative AI systems actually work so you can understand what makes them powerful, but also what makes them vulnerable. For access to the labs, supporting materials, and tools like Parrot, go ahead to aka.ms/AIRT101. See you next time.